What is up, guys? It's Matt the Gem Rat, and today we are talking about Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition. Alright, so Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition is a remaster of Tales of Vesperia, which was released in 2009. Tales of Vesperia is a single-player JRPG, which is part of the series of Tales of Games by Bandai Namco. Alright guys, so let's go into the good and the bads, and then I'm actually going to do a review today, so I'm going to give y'all what I think about the entire game overall. So let's start off with the good. Now, the first thing to look at is it's a great story-driven single-player game. The story is full of meaningful character interactions where everybody you meet just seems like a new story, something new to learn about the game, and everything that you talk about basically is completely applicable to the story itself, so you never feel like you're really wasting time talking to people, you know, spending a little bit extra time on storylines and things like that. Everything just kind of connects together, and it's very nice to sit there and meet new people, you know, just add on to the storyline that you're already so elaborately working on. Along with this large, intricate storyline comes a big open world, which is open for exploration, and it's completely awesome. It keeps the story fresh, keeps the settings new, keeps things from getting stale. You're constantly going different places, you know, going across the sea, going into the desert, finding new enemies, finding new cities, and it keeps the game fresh, especially when you're playing for 30 plus, 40 plus hours on this game. If you're trying to beat it, it keeps the game fresh, it keeps new settings, and you don't get stuck in the same spots for hours and hours. Because of this, it gives you hours and hours of gameplay where you're constantly exploring the world, exploring maps, certain things like that, and just finding new things to fight, new character interactions, and other things like that. I also really enjoyed the fighting in this game. It was simple yet really rewarding when you pulled off the right ability at that time or pulled off combos to beat multiple enemies or even one large enemy at that certain point when you knew you had low HP. It was awesome to do that, yet, you know, it wasn't too complex to where you couldn't pull off those combos or you couldn't block certain attacks. It was very nice and fluid, and it made fighting an enjoyment at the end of the day. The game's menus were super easy to navigate and easy to use. They weren't big and elaborate like most of the RPGs that you play nowadays. They're super simple. You could read everything in one or two sentences and know what they do. You could go between your abilities, your skills, and also your items to heal, even the food that you were going to cook. All these things you could do in the menu was super easy to navigate, and you could find everything you needed within a couple button clicks. And within the menus, you could set certain strategies, which were awesome. So whenever you're going into a large boss battle, you could set things like who's going to do what, who's going to heal, who's going to do ranged attacks, who's going to do close attacks, things like that, which made the game that much more satisfying whenever you beat large bosses by just setting up these strategies, setting up positions for your players, and then also controlling that. So that was another really good part, was setting strategies for battles and things like that.
Let's proceed quietly.
This is my house. Nobody else's. This is my house. Later, bro.
Alright, now moving on from the good to the bad. Not everything in this game was perfect, so I'm gonna let y'all know what I thought was not that satisfying in the game. Alright, so the first thing was the long cutscenes. Now, there are certain times when you felt like you were in a conversation for much longer than you needed to be, and you really just wanted to button mash your way out of that conversation. Also, the fighting in the game can become a hassle when you're just trying to make your way through certain paths or certain parts. There's just constantly monsters in your way that you have to fight and beat, and it just becomes a hassle. But all in all, that's really the only bad things I have to say about the game. So ending on this note, if you're looking for a single player JRPG that you can spend countless hours on and just relax, maybe sit on the couch and play it, this is the game for you. So, the rating. I'm very, very much stiff on ratings. I do not like to give people high ratings. But this game, without a doubt, you're looking for a single-player JRPG, which is what I was looking for. It's an 8 out of 10. Yes, 8 out of 10. Alright guys, that's all for me. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please leave a like. It helps me out a lot. Make sure to hit the subscribe if you want to keep up with all the great content I'm putting out, and hit the notification bell if you really like me a lot and you want to get updates on when I put out content. But that's it for me, Matt the Gym Rat. Please remember that lifting and gaming is life. Y'all be cool, and I'll catch y'all in the next video.
Night like Nick, Drake and Josh, how we team your bitch, Michael Jackson, one glove I hit, crying in the club with my stick, Icky Vicky spit, how I got slimes on deck, metal on lady, just flick big, Two girls, two cups, no, I had to level up, ate a Mario mushroom quick, No, these niggas be chickens like a nugget, they be just actors, there's a Washington, I'm a